Hello everybody, this is Dave from Retired Time Productions, and this is another Magix Movie Edit Pro video. Now I haven't put up one for a while, I apologize to my Magix Movie Edit Pro viewers, but I've been kind of busy with other things. But I'm going to get one up right now, and the first thing, I want to cover a couple things. The first thing I want to cover is that in the index of this video, in other words in the description of the video, there's a complete listing of all the Magix Movie Edit Pro tutorials I've done so far. Now if you're just getting into Magix and you want to learn how to do it, then there's a couple of videos right at the top that are tutorials about how to make a complete movie step by step for the beginner, shows you everything you need to do to use Magix Movie Edit Pro. And then there's more in-depth videos on some of the subcomponents of Magix and how to use them, the effects and whatnot that come with the package. Now I always suggest that you get Magix Movie Edit Pro Plus. Get the Plus version because it has the extra goodies and effects and templates and things you need to really enhance your videos. So I always make that a point to get the Plus version. There's a premium version that's a little more expensive, but your price break is right there on the Plus. There's also a standard version, but it doesn't have all the goodies. So right in the middle is the Plus. And I'll put a link in the description under the video on where you can go to the Magix site and look at those three versions. Okay, now the second thing I want to cover is making your PC perform better with Magix, or even tuning Magix to make it perform better. I know some of you have had questions like, why does Magix lock up, or why is my preview jittery or jerky, stuff like that. So I want to cover that. So those two things basically what's going to be in this video. So if you're not interested in any of that, you can just stop watching now. If you are, just stay tuned and I'm going to talk about some more. Okay, so if you don't already know, Magix only runs on the PC. I haven't seen an Apple version of it out yet. So if you got a Mac, you probably don't have Magix Movie Edit Pro, so you can just stop watching. But for the PC users, what we have to do is make sure that Magix is supported by the proper resources in your PC. Now I want to go through those minimum resources. Now often I'll record on or edit on a notebook, and a notebook computer is fine. You know, they're not as powerful as the desktops when, you know, comparing hardware, but a notebook is fine. But what I suggest for either a notebook or a desktop is, first of all, get a pretty good processor, because most of your power in your editing is coming from the processor on your motherboard. And I would suggest just get an i7, but if you don't have the money, you can use an i5. But there's not that big a difference between the i5 and the i7 now. So, you know, as time has gone on, the i7's getting older and it's cheaper. So I would just go with the i7. And make sure you get enough cores. I can't emphasize this enough. Usually the i7 comes with 4 cores, so there's no problem, but I would suggest at least 4 cores. If you got extra money to spend, then you can get 6 cores. There's some processors out there that have, I think, up to 8, but you can look and see what you can come up with. But 4 cores is ample on the processor. Now, second to the processor, when you're running your preview and you're going through video effects like 3D effects or transitions and stuff, a lot of that is done on the video card in the GPU. And the GPU on the video card can vary in power just like the CPU on the computer. So what I suggest and what I've been using is the, and I'm going to name a brand, I probably shouldn't do this, but for example, the nVida Geforce series is very good. And you can get a card for under $100 that'll do the trick. And I would suggest on the card itself, on the video card, to have at least 2 gig of memory, because that'll speed up the processing that's done in the GPU, such as those effects and transitions and things. And it'll make your playback smoother if you have those effects in your timeline. So I would suggest that. Now, as far as the computer memory, I'm just saying 2 gig on the memory card, on the video card, but on the computer, I would recommend at least 8 gig. Start there. And 8 gig should be enough. It should be ample for whatever you're doing. Unless you're doing 4K video, then you probably need a whole new machine, more on the order of a gaming machine that's really powerful. But I'm just talking about your ordinary editing and up to 1080p. And I do a lot of editing in 1080p, and these resources work good. So 8 gig is plenty. If you can afford it, go to 16 gig. But above 16 gig, you really don't get much bang for your buck. So from 8 to 16 gig on the motherboard on your computer, 2 gig on the video card. Now, you're going to need hard drive space, because with video, it just eats up the hard drive space, especially in 1080p. If you get to 4K, it'll really eat it. But we're just talking about 1080 here. So I would suggest at least a extra terabyte drive, like have a second drive with a terabyte of memory on it. And it can be an external drive. If it's a notebook, you can put it externally. My notebook happens to have 2 bays, so I can have 2 drives. So I have a system drive and then a 1 terabyte video drive where I store my movies. And I actually edit off that drive too. So I got all my movie stuff on a separate drive, not on the system. So that way, if the system drive crashes, you don't lose all your information. So that's what I suggest there for the hard drive. For the monitor, it's good if you can get at least a 21-inch high-resolution monitor. I would recommend at least 1280 by 768, but I think you can get more now, like 1920 or something like that. Just get at least a 1280 by 768 resolution. And make sure the video card will handle that too, although most of them will. Okay, so I've been using my notebook for a while, and my notebook actually has an nVida Geforce 630M with 2 gig of memory, and it works just fine. It has an i7 with 4 cores. Finally, people have asked, you know, why is my movie jerky? We've been just talking about that, and some of the reason is, as I just suggested, your computer just doesn't have the proper resources and you need to beef it up a little bit or just get a new computer. But if you can't afford to do that, there are some things you can do. One of them is to make sure that there's no other processes running while you're editing. Like if you got a browser running, you know, it's on the internet looking at things, close it down. On my notebook, sometimes I just put my notebook in airplane mode so there's no internet connected to it, because sometimes Windows starts doing updates right while you're editing. It may not actually install them, but it'll be downloading updates over the internet, and that slows down your process and may even cause the computer to lock up. So close your browsers, maybe even turn off your internet. The other thing is make sure there's no other processes running that are unnecessary. Like you can open up Task Manager by doing holding down Control and Alt and then Delete. And then in the menu, you can pick Task Manager. Just look at the Processes tab. See what's running. Maybe there's stuff in there that you didn't even know was running that you don't need. Sometimes we install programs for devices that we no longer have, or there's some kind of update services running. Just different things. And you can go and actually close those tasks while you're editing. And then the next time you boot up your computer, they'll come back. So the Task Manager doesn't remove them, it just kills them. So you can do that. And the other thing you can do, and I'll put a link for this under the video, but if you go to the Magix site, magix.com, you can go to your version of Magix Movie Edit Pro, and then there'll be a link for tutorials. Go to that, and they have a few short tutorials in there. And one of them is on optimization, optimizing your PC, and optimizing basically going into Magix, and there's a bunch of little tweaks you can do in Magix. Now, I don't have time in this video to go through them all, but I will probably do that later and make a video just on the tweaks that you can do to Magix. But if you just watch their video, they show you in a few little steps how you can make some quick tweaks to make your preview smoother, make your editing smoother, and it'll be easier on you because it won't lock up as much. So that's what I would suggest. I'll put that link again in the description to the Magix tutorials. And you look through the list of tutorials and find that one on optimization. and just watch that one, and I think that'll help. Okay, so in closing, don't forget to look in the description under the video for that index of all my Magix Movie Edit Pro tutorials, and I think that'll help you out if you're new to Magix or just want to know a few things extra about Magix. I've got a lot of tutorials in there about different things, and I'll be adding more to that index as we go along, including this one. So I hope that helps everybody out. I'm just trying to get everybody up and running. Magix is really a good program, but sometimes it just needs a good foundation and for it to work properly. And after that, you're good to go. So we'll talk to you later. We'll see you on the tube. Leave any comments you want under the video. And don't forget to like and subscribe if you want to. If you didn't like the video, hey, give me a thumbs down. I don't care. I say it's always good for ratings. But we'll see you later. And sorry I haven't got more Magix Movie Edit Pro videos out, but we'll try to do more in the future. Bye for now.